hardware required to start programming with CC2541. Here you can get module JDY08. This module you can program from data and clock pin. Another module is H10. This module comes with that firmware already flash in it. For flashing and debugging we required CC debugger. It's very hard to find this debugger in Indian electronics shop. So I ordered it from eBay.
We will set up a CC2541 BLE module for debugging and programming it through IAR workbench. So let's begin. First, you have to download the IAR workbench. At IAR website, you will find the other TI wireless microcontrollers. So you have to find out for CC2541. Here, click on the 8051 tools. So basically, IAR is a paid with compiler. So we can use it as a for a student or evaluation purpose. So there is some restriction. There are two type of trial versions. One is limited to time and other is limited to code size. So basically code size is 4K. If we go with this, then the TI CC2541 BLE stack will not gonna compile because it's exceeds memory. So we have to download it with trial. So it will give you 30 days. So either you go with your own machine or you can try it in any virtual machine. So basically you have to install VirtualBox and you can go with this. So after the expiring software, you can reinstall the operating system and you can use IR workbench continuously. So I am going to install it on my own system. So basically I have to download this software. So here it will start download. I have already downloaded and installed this IR workbench, so I will not gonna install it. So next thing is you have to install a CC2541 BLE stack, or maybe it's called as a TI BLE stack. So just Google it. On TI website you can find that BLE stack. There are also other BLE stack which supports particular MCUs. So basically we are going with this BLE stack 1.4.2 because it supports the CC2541 IC. So we can download it from here. So just click on download. Before that you have to create your account on a TI website. So you can create it. So you have to just fill up the information. I already have the account. Before download we have to submit this, then our download link will be appear here. So basically if you download this stack, this is nothing but the exe file which after you have to install it. So you will get the email about the verification that you have started downloading the stack. So this is the exe file and this is our IR workbench. So you have to first install the IR workbench, then you can install this BLE stack for that TI microcontroller. So here I already downloaded the software I required. So basically first one is the IR Workbench 10.3. This is a IR Workbench 9.10. If there is a old project, you can also use this, or you can also go with this 10.3. So both will be work for me. So the next file is Smart RF Studio. So basically it also you can download from the TI website. This is the Flash programmer. So basically this will flash your hex file into CC2541 BLE chip. So this is a BLE stack 1.4.2. This is the documents related to that BLE stack, and other don't require any. So basically you have to just install this file and this file. After installing this Smart RF Studio, you have to configure the path for this Flash programmer. So I already installed this AIR Workbench and BLE stack, so we have to install this one. So you can run as an administrator. So its default location is under C. So here is Texas Instruments folder will be created. You can go to this folder. Here inside project folder you can find all the sample codes which is implemented on CC2541. So basically we are going to use this one. This is a simple BLE peripheral. So its installation is finished. So let's start AIR Workbench. So this is a 9.9 version. So this is a 10.3. So let's open this. Here I already have the project, so I just remove it. So it's showing me that the IR license manager is showing me that the license is expired, so I have to renew it. So basically you can renew this by using any other email address. So go to your help. This is a IR license manager. You have to put registration key in this license manager so you can use your IR Workbench. So it's showing me that the license is already expired. I need a new license key. This is the license number. So go to this and click on get evaluation license. So here you have to put new license key. So go on register. Here you have to check for a time limited which you will get 30 days, and you have to put your information. So basically I have put here fake information, so it's okay. I will it's give me a 30 day trial version. So what we have to do here, you have email address, so you can your own Gmail address or go for a temporary email address website. So basically I use Mailinator. This is a very simple and basic website which provide a fake email addresses. So just choose any random email address. So this is a email address here, so copy this and paste here. Basically this is the address. We will get the email here. So other information is all fake information. You can use anything here. Just select the random options and click on submit registration. So there is some problem showing here. So I have to select this one also. So they are saying that you have sent a mail. So let's check here. So here you will get a email from the IR systems. Click on it. Then you have to click on this. So here is your new license number. Just copy this and go to here. Paste it here and click on next. It will show you your license status here. So here is our license is renewed. So you can go and use your IR workbench. So go to your open workspace and navigate to your BLE stack. So I will go with the simple BLE peripheral. Here you have two chips, that is a CC2540 and CC2541. Open CC2541 folder and you have to choose this file. So the folder containing the project is for old version of IR Workbench. So it will convert automatically for a newer version. So here is your project. So what we have to do for compile this project, basically just you have to select this configuration. Out of this, if you choose this configuration, it will work for a key fob which is manufactured by TI. So it is basically sensor tag. So don't choose it, just go for a second option only, CC2541. Then only your project will get compiled and it will work on your bare CC2541. So just select project and click on rebuild. So here you can see all the project is get compiled, there is no any error. So basically this project is compiled successfully. So what next we have to do, there is a debugging option for here. So basically if I click on this, IR Workbench will download this program to chip and start debugging and set the pointer at this main function. So you can navigate this by stepping. So just I run this program and that we can find this in a software. You can get the CC2541 is detected, it's a BLE device. So just quick navigation through this sample BLE code. So I just not go in a deep, I just explain the basic functionality how it works. So basically this implementation is like a operating system, like you have to create a task and the task will get executed by priorities, like a round robin queue. So you can find this file. So here is a main function at the simple BLE peripheral main.c. In this enter point function, they are initialize the operating system and other interrupts. So basically our code goes in this file simple BLE peripheral.c. So this is our main loop for our task, that we can perform different periodic tasks and all events get called here. So what inside this, they have created the event which is produced by system and other. So we can cache these events here and perform our task. So basically they have given a simple periodic task over here. So they have defined the period for this task. Like this, this task will call after every 5 seconds. So they have started a timer for the task. After this timer will get expired, this event will arise. So in this if loop, you can compare the which event is occur. So if this event will occur, then restart the timer and perform the periodic task. So this periodic task you can find here. So basically what they are doing, they are reading the characteristic 3 and send that characteristic data on to the characteristic 4. Basically this example consists of a GATT server. So they have totally 5 characteristic. So for that configuration you have to look for the file here. Sorry, for this simple GATT profile. So basically they have all the GATT profile configuration is stored here. So you have, if you have to add any characteristic or delete any characteristic, change the properties of that characteristic, so you can do that all thing here. In this is very important file for the GATT server. So you have to modify what your architecture of your GATT server, so what profiles you need, what services you need, so you can configure all here. So basically if we go from the top, this is the UID configuration for each GATT service. Also you can find this in a header file of this file. Here you can see the numbers are given to each characteristic, then the UID changes for each characteristic, data length here is for characteristic 5 is 5. So characteristic 5 only can send the 5 bytes of data at a time, other characteristic just send 1 byte of data. So you can modify here up to the 517. That is a fixed length for a GATT server. Then this all the GATT server callbacks. Let's go to this file again. So here is each characteristic is configured like their properties, read property, write property, then notification and indications. Or also this is a descriptor, user descriptor name. So basically each, in this example they are given like every characteristic have two descriptors. One is for notification and indication enabling, and other is a user descriptor that the user can send any information about that characteristic. So your fourth characteristic is having a property of notification. So basically there is indication and notification. The notification only sends the data and not wait for the acknowledgement. But if you use indication, it will just wait for the acknowledgement and confirm that data is get sent over the GATT server. So basically for any particular purpose you can use indication here. So next is characteristic attribute table. So basically this table is also related to characteristic information and their properties. So here you have to define all the characteristic with service and profile means here service. So the next is characteristic one properties, their UID, then permissions, and this is a profile change one. This is a simple handler used for handle each characteristic. So it should be there for every characteristic. So here is 5 characteristic they define. The next thing is a read and write callback. So basically if you connect mobile to your CC2541 chip, and if someone reads the characteristic, then this callback will occur. and so if someone write on characteristic, this callback will occur. So basically here they don't, they already use this, but for simple purpose they have implemented two other function like set parameters, like simple profile set parameters, and other is get parameter. So basically this function is very useful, very simple. Instead of using read write callbacks, so we use here set parameter and get parameter. So basically all profiles are if someone if you want to send data to the GAT server from CC2541 to mobile, so here you have to set that value to the characteristic profile. Like this is a value defined here. So initially it is 0. So you can set it for characteristic 4. Here they are sending notification, so it is not writing, it is just notify at any particular time to the characteristic 4. And also here for characteristic 5, it is a variable length characteristic. They already we have defined it for 5, so you can send a 5 byte of data on characteristic 5. And also this characteristic 5 also have a authentication property, which means you have to accept a connection and put your default password for the CC2541, then only you can send and receive data over this. Similarly the get function will read the coming data on CC2541 from a GAT server. So basically we don't have to use directly these functions. So but if you are you have to modify some characteristic, you have also modify this function. So basically here some limitation that they have given, like if the length is not equal to 1, so it will be invalid value. So here you have to change for your particular application. So coming back to our function, so here you are getting the characteristic 3 data and sending it over the 4. So it is basic implementation of simple peripheral device. There is also other things like how to set password, then device name, then other information related to device. You can change it here, like company ID on all the raw broadcasting data, you can change it here. So here is device name is given, which is in a ASCII format, but you have to put equivalent hex data for that ASCII characteristic. Here they are defined the time interval for broadcasting the data, then transmitter power and all the things are defined here. So basically this is functionality of CC2541.